Good morning. Today we will see the solved question paper of October 2018, that is of 2010 scheme. So the first question is, mention normal respiratory rate, explain oxygen transport in blood and add a note on hypoxia. Oxygen is transported from the alveoli to the tissue by the blood in two forms, that is simple diffuse physical solution and second is in combination with hemoglobin. As a simple physical solution, oxygen dissolves in the water or plasma and is transported in this physical form. The amount of oxygen transported by this way is negligible, that is only 3% of total oxygen is in the blood. It is because of poor solubility of oxygen in water content of the plasma. The second method is in combination with hemoglobin. Oxygen combined with hemoglobin in the blood and is transported as oxyhemoglobin. This transport is important because 97% of oxygen by transported by this method combination with hemoglobin, only a physical combination. It is only oxygenation and not oxidation. That means oxygen is readily released from hemoglobin when it is needed. Hemoglobin accepts oxygen readily whenever partial pressure of oxygen in the blood is more. Hemoglobin gives out whenever the partial pressure of oxygen in the blood is less. Oxygen combines with the iron in the heme part of hemoglobin. Each molecule of hemoglobin contains 4 atoms of iron. The iron of hemoglobin is present in the ferrous form. Each iron atom combines with 1 molecule of the oxygen. After combination with oxygen, the hemoglobin is called oxygenation and not oxidation. The oxygen carrying capacity of the blood refers to the amount of oxygen transported by the blood. 1 gram Hb carries 1.3 ml of oxygen. It is called the oxygen carrying capacity of the hemoglobin. The oxygen capacity of the blood is 19 ml because Hb is not fully saturated with oxygen. It is saturated only for about 95%. The oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is the curve that demonstrates the relationship between partial pressure of oxygen and percentage of saturation of Hb with oxygen. It explains the hemoglobin's affinity for oxygen. Normally in the blood, the hemoglobin is saturated with oxygen only up to 95%. When the partial pressure of oxygen is more, the Hb accepts oxygen, and when the partial pressure of oxygen is less, Hb releases the oxygen. Hypoxia is defined as reduced availability of oxygen to the tissue. The term anoxia refers to absence of oxygen. In olden days, the term anoxia was in use. Since there is no possibility for total absence of use in the living condition, use of this term is abandoned. 4 important factors which lead to hypoxia are oxygen tension in the arterial blood, oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, velocity of the blood flow, and utilization of oxygen by the cells. On the basis of the above factors, the hypoxia is classified into 4 types. They are hypoxic hypoxia, anemic hypoxia, stagnant hypoxia, and histotoxic hypoxia. Each type of hypoxia may be acute or chronic simultaneously. 2 or more types of hypoxia may be present together. Acute and severe hypoxia lead to unconsciousness. If not treated immediately, the brain death occurs. Chronic hypoxia produces various symptoms in the body. Effects of hypoxia are of 2 types, that is immediate effect and delayed effect. The treatment of hypoxia is oxygen therapy. The best treatment for hypoxia is oxygen therapy, that is treating affected person with oxygen, pure oxygen or oxygen combined with another gas is administered. Oxygen therapy is carried out in 2 methods, by placing the patient's head in a tent containing oxygen and by allowing the patient to breathe oxygen either from a mask or an intranasal tube. Depending upon the situation, oxygen therapy can be given under either normal atmosphere pressure or under high pressure. Second question, discuss blood groups in detail, adenotron transfusion reaction. Determination of ABO blood groups depend upon the immunological reaction between antigen and antibody. Landsteiner found 2 antigens in the blood RBC that named as antigen A and antigen B. These antigens also called agglutinogens because of their capacity to cause agglutination of the RBC. Based on the presence or absence of antigen A and antigen B, the blood group is divided into 4 groups. They are A group, B group, AB group, and O group. The blood having antigen A is called as group A and the beta, and this group A have beta antibody in the serum. The blood group with B antigen is called B group, and they have alpha antibody in the serum. If both the antigens are present, the blood is called AB group, and the serum of this group does not contain any antibody. If both antigens are absent, the blood group is called O group. They have both alpha and beta antibodies present in the serum. In ABO system, the O group is the universal donor, as they contain no agglutinogens and not agglutinated by antibodies or members of other groups. AB is the universal recipient. They contain no antibody in the serum and can receive blood from any group. Importance of blood group determination. Nowadays, knowledge of the blood group is a very key essential medically, socially and judicially. The importance of knowing the blood groups are, first, medically, it's important during the blood transfusion, tissue transplant. Socially, one should know her blood group and become a member of blood donor club so that she or she can be approached for blood donation during emergency condition. In general, among couples, knowledge of the blood group helps to prevent complications due to Rh incompatibility and save the child from the disorders like erythroblastosis fetalis. Judicially, it's helpful in medico-legal cases to sort out paternity disputes. Transfusion reactions due to ABO incompatibility. Transfusion reactions are the adverse reactions in the body which occur due to transfusion errors that involve the compatibility or mismatched blood. Reactions may be mild, causing only fever and high hives, or may be severe, leading to renal failure, shock, and death. In mismatched transfusion, the transfusion reactions occur between donors' RBC and recipient's plasma. So, donors' plasma contains agglutinins against recipient RBC, and agglutination does not occur because of this antibody are diluted in the recipient's blood. But the recipient's plasma contains agglutinins against donor's RBC, the immune system launches a response against new blood cells. The donor RBC are agglutinated, resulting in transfusion reaction. The cause for transfusion reactions are incompatible blood produced hemolytic reactions. The recipient's antibody, that is IgG or IgM, adhere to the donor RBC, which are agglutinated and destroyed. Large amounts of free hemoglobin is liberated into the plasma. This leads to transfusion reaction. Transfusion reactions due to Rh incompatibility. When an Rh negative person receives Rh positive blood for the first time, he is not affected much since the reaction do not occur immediately, but the antibodies will develop within the 1 month. Transfused RBC that are still present in the recipient's blood are agglutinated. These agglutinated cells are lysed by macrophages. So, delayed transfusion reaction occurs, but it is normally mild, does not affect the recipient. However, antibodies developed in the recipient remain in the body forever. So, when this person receives Rh positive blood for the second time, the donor RBCs are agglutinated and severe transfusion reaction occur immediately. Short note, functions of placenta, nutritive function. That nutritive substance, electrolyte, hormones necessary for the development of the fetus diffuse from mother's blood into the fetal blood to the placenta. Excretory function. Metabolic end products and other waste products from the fetal body are excreted into the mother's blood to the placenta. Respiratory function. Fetal lungs are non-functioning and the placenta forms the respiratory organ for the fetus. Oxygen necessary for the fetus is received by diffusion from the maternal blood, and carbon dioxide from the fetal blood diffuses into the maternal blood to the placenta. Endocrine function. Hormones secreted by the placenta are human chorionic gonadotropin, estrogen, progesterone, human chorionic somatomammotropin, and relaxin. The next short note is cerebrospinal fluid. CSF is a clear, colorless, transparent fluid that circulates through the ventricles of brain, subarachnoid space, and central canal of the spinal cord. The properties are: volume is around 150 ml and rate of formation is 0.3 ml per minute. Specific gravity is 1.005. Reaction is alkaline. The circulation: major quantity of the CSF is formed in the lateral ventricle and passes through the foramen of Monroe in the third ventricle. From here, it passes through the aqueductus sylvius. From the fourth ventricle, it enters to cisterna margina and cisterna lateralis through the foramen lusca. A portion of cisternal fluid circulates through the spinal subarachnoid space. The greater part of the fluid passes upwards over the brainstem to the cerebral hemispheres. Functions: protective function. The specific gravity of the brain and CSF is more or less same brain float in the CSF. When the head receives a blow, CSF act like a cushion and prevent the movements of brain against the skull bone, thereby prevent damage of the brain. Regulation of cranial content volume. If the cranial content increases in volume, there is an increase in absorption of substance into the venous sinus. This happens in case of cerebral hemorrhage and tumors of brain. Medium of exchange. CSF is a medium through which many substances, particularly nutritive substances and waste materials, are exchanged between blood and brain tissues. Functions of platelets. First one is rolling clotting. The platelets are responsible for the formation of intrinsic prothrombin activation and is responsible for the onset of blood clotting. Rolling clot retraction. In blood clot, blood cells including platelets are entrapped between the fibrin threads. Cytoplasm of the platelets contain contractile proteins, namely acetin, myosin, thrombocytin, and which is responsible for the clot retraction. The third one is role in prevention of blood loss. The platelets accelerate hemostasis by three ways. That is, first, by it secrete a 5-HT which causes constriction of blood vessels. Due to the adhesive property, platelets seal the damage in the blood vessels like a capillaries, and by formation of a temporary plaque, platelets seal the damage in the blood vessels. Next, role in the repair of ruptured blood vessels. Platelet-derived growth factor formed in cytoplasm of the platelets is useful for the repair of endothelium and other structures of ruptured blood vessels. Role in defense mechanism. By the property of agglutination, platelets encircle the foreign bodies and destroy them. Functions of liver. Liver is the largest organ in the body. The main functions are, first one is metabolic function. Liver is the organ where the maximum metabolic reactions are carried out. It plays an important role in energy metabolism. Metabolism of carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins, and many hormones are carried out in the liver. Storage function. Many substances like glycogen, amino acid, iron, folic acid, and vitamins A, B12, and D are stored in the liver. Synthetic function. Liver produces glucose by gluconeogenesis. It synthesizes all plasma proteins and other processes, clot refractories, complement factors, and hormone binding proteins. It also synthesizes steroids, somatostatin, and heparin. Secretion of bile. Liver secretes bile, which contains bile salt, bile pigment, cholesterol, fatty acid, and lecithin. The functions of bile are many due to the bile salt. The bile salts are required for the digestion and absorption of fat in the intestine. Excretory function. Liver excretes cholesterol, bile pigment, heavy metals, toxins, bacteria, and virus. Heat production. Enormous amount of heat is produced in the liver because of the metabolic reactions. Hematopoietic function. The fetus liver produces blood cells, it stores vitamin B12 and iron necessary for synthesis of hemoglobin. Hemolytic function. Senile RBCs after 1-2 days are destroyed by the reticuloendothelial cells of the liver. Inactivation of hormone and drugs. Liver catabolizes hormones such as growth hormone, parathormone, cortisol, insulin, glucagons, and estrogen. It also inactivates drugs, particularly fat-soluble drugs. Defense and detoxification function. Foreign bodies, such as bacteria or antigens, are swallowed and digested by the reticuloendothelial cells. Reticuloendothelial cells of liver also involved in the production of some substances like tumor necrosis factors. Liver cells involved in the removal of toxic property of harm agents called detoxification. Formation of urine. Kidney excrete unwanted substances including metabolic waste products and those subjects which are present in the excess quantities in the body through urine. The formation in the three processes they are. First one is glomerular filtration. When the blood passes through the glomerular capillaries, the plasma is filtered into the Bowman's capsule. All substances of plasma are filtered except plasma protein. The filtered fluid is called as glomerular filtrate. GFR is defined as the total amount of ultrafiltrate formed by the nephrons of both kidney per minute. The factors which affect GFR are blood pressure in the glomerular capillaries to the extent of 60 mm of mercury, colloid osmotic pressure around 32 mm of mercury, and hydrostatic pressure in the Bowman's capsule around 18 mm of mercury. Second is tubular absorption. When GFR flows, the tubular portion of the nephron, both quantitative and qualitative changes occur. Since the substances are taken back to the blood from the glomerular filtrate, the entire process is called as tubular reabsorption. the selective reabsorption. The tubular cells of the kidney selectively reabsorb substance present in the glomerular filtrate. The substance which are necessary for the body, such as glucose, amino acids, vitamins, are completely reabsorbed from the renal tubule, where as unwanted substances like metabolic waste are not reabsorbed. The mechanism of reabsorption by active reabsorption and passive reabsorption. Active reabsorption is the movement of molecules against the electrochemical gradient. The substances are sodium, potassium, phosphate, sulfate, bicarbonates, glucose, amino acid, ascorbic acid, uric acid, and ketone bodies. Passive reabsorption is in these molecules move along the electrochemical gradient. The substances absorbed are chloride, urea, and water. Tubular secretions. In addition to reabsorption from the renal tubule, some substances are secreted to the lumen from the peritubular capillaries to the tubular epithelial cells. It is known as tubular secretion. The main substance secreted are para-aminohippuric acid, diodorast, hydroxylacetic acid, amino derivatives, and penicillin. Functions of hypothalamus. The disencephalic structure situated just below the thalamus is the ventral part of the cephalons. Hypothalamus is an important part in the brain concerned with homeostasis of the body. It regulates many vital functions like endocrine functions, visceral functions, metabolic activities, hunger, thirst, sleep, wakefulness, emotions, sexual functions, etc. Secretion of posterior pituitary hormones. The hypothalamus is a source of secretion of posterior pituitary hormones, ADH, and oxytocin are secreted by supraoptic and paraventricular nuclei. Control of antipituitary. Hypothalamus controls the antipituitary gland by secreting releasing hormone and inhibitory hormones. It secretes seven hormones. They are growth hormone releasing hormone, growth hormone releasing polypeptide, growth hormone inhibitory hormone, thyrotropic hormone, corticotropin releasing hormone, gonadotropin releasing hormone, and prolactin inhibiting hormone. Control of adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex regulated by ACTH. ACTH secretion is in turn regulated by CRH, which is secreted by the paraventricular nucleus of hypothalamus. Control of adrenal medulla and regulation of autonomic nervous system. The sympathetic division of autonomic nervous system is regulated by posterior and lateral nuclei of hypothalamus. Then regulation of heart rate. Hypothalamus regulates heart rate through vasomotor center in the medulla oblongata. Regulation of blood pressure by acting as a vasomotor center. Regulation of body temperature, regulation of food intake, regulation of sleep and wakefulness, role of behavior and emotional changes, regulation of sexual function, regulation in response to smell. Myxedema. Myxedema is the condition is marked by thickening, swelling of the tongue caused by insufficient production of thyroid hormone by the thyroid gland. The function of thyroid hormone is to regulate our metabolism. Myxedema associated with other symptoms are underactive thyroid, also called hypothyroidism, including lethargy, weight gain, fatigue, depression, and cold insensitivity, among others. Hypothyroidism is more common in women, especially in those over age of 50, and can be caused by a viral infection, certain medications, radiation exposure, autoimmune disease, or inherited congenital disorders. Myxedema caused by hypothyroidism and it occurs most commonly in the hypothyroidism is left untreated. Depending upon the cause, myxedema can be treated with thyroid replacement hormones. These medications are effective in eliminating the symptoms that accompany myxedema and hypothyroidism. Initially, thyroid replacement medication probably need to be taken them for the rest of the life. If left untreated, myxedema can have serious or rarely life-threatening complications. Mitochondria. Mitochondria is the membrane-bound cytoplasm which is concerned with the production of energy. It is a rod-shaped or oval-shaped structure with diameter of 0.521. It is covered by bilayered membrane. Outer membrane is smooth and encloses contains mitochondrion. The membrane contains various enzymes like acetyl-CoA enzyme synthetase and glycerol phosphate acetyl transferase. The inner membrane is folded in the form of a shelf-like inward projection called crista and is covered by inner matrix space. The crista contain many enzymes and other protein molecules which are involved in the respiration and synthesis of adenosine triphosphatase. Because of these functions, the enzymes and other protein molecules in the crista are collectively known as the respiratory chain or electron transport system. Functions include production of energy. Mitochondria is called as the powerhouse or power plant of the cell because it produces energy required for the cellular functions. Synthesis of ATP. Components of respiratory chain in the mitochondria are responsible for synthesis of ATP by utilizing energy by oxidation of phosphorylation. Apoptosis, the cytochrome C second mitochondria derived from the activated capsule secreted in the mitochondria involved in the apoptosis. And other functions include mitochondria include storage of calcium, detoxification of ammonia in the liver. Neuron. Neuron or nerve cell is defined as the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. It is similar to any other cell body but having a large nucleus with organelles in the cytoplasm. However, it is different in other ways. By the first neuron has branches or process called axon and dendrites. Neuron does not have the centrosome that it cannot undergo division. Classification of neuron. Neurons are classified by three different methods depending upon number of pairs. They are unipolar, bipolar, and multipolar neurons. Depending upon the function, they are motor or efferent neurons and sensory or afferent neuron. Depending upon length of the neuron, they are Golgi type 1 neurons and Golgi type 2 neurons. Functions of gallbladder. Major function of gallbladder is the storage and conservation of bile. Storage of bile. Bile is continuously secreted from the liver, but it is released in the intestine only intermittently, and most of the bile stored in the gallbladder till it is required. Second is concentration of bile. Bile is concentrated while it is stored in the gallbladder. The mucus of the gallbladder rapidly reabsorbs water and electrolyte except calcium and potassium. But the bile salt, bile pigment, cholesterol and lecithin are not reabsorbed. So the concentration of this substance in the bile increases 5 to 10 times. Alteration of pH of bile. The pH of bile decreases from 8 to 8.6 to 7 to 7.6 and it is become less alkaline when it is stored in the gallbladder. Secretion of mucin. Gallbladder secrete mucin and act to the bile. When the bile is released to the intestine, the mucin acts as a lubricant for the movement of chyme in the intestine. Maintenance of pressure in the biliary system. Due to the concentrating capacity, gallbladder maintains a pressure about 7 cm of water in the biliary system. This pressure in the biliary system is essential for the release of bile into the intestine. Reflex arc. Reflex activity is the response of the peripheral nervous stimulus that occurs without our consciousness. It is a type of protective mechanism. It protects body from irreparable damage. The reflex arc is the anatomical nervous pathway of reflex action. In a simple reflex arc have 5 components. They are the receptor, the afferent nerve, the sender, efferent nerve, effector organ. Myopia. Myopia is the eye defect characterized by inability to see the distant object, otherwise known as short-sightedness. In myopia, the far point is infinity. A near vision is normal, but it is far point is in, that is at different side. The causes include myopia is the refractive power of the lens is usually normal, but the anteroposterior diameter of the eyeball abnormally long. Therefore, the image is brought to focus little in front of retina. The light rays comes after coming to a focus, disperse again, so the blurred image is formed upon the retina. The myopic cell eye is corrected by using biconcave lens. Light rays diverge by the concave lens before entering the eye. Ovulation. Ovulation is the process by which the graafene follicle in the ovary ruptures and ovum is released in the abdominal cavity. The ovulation on the 14th day of the menstrual cycle in a normal cycle of 28 days. The ovum which is released in the abdominal cavity enters the fallopian tube to the fibrinated end of the tube. Usually only one ovum released at one ovulation in response for the ovulation. Stages of ovulation are graafene follicle moves to the periphery of the ovary. The new blood vessels are formed in the ovary by actions of LH and progesterone. These blood vessels protrude into the sperm, the wall of the follicle. This increases the blood flow to the follicle. Now the prostaglandin is released from granulosa cells of follicle. It causes leakage of plasma into the follicle. Just before the ovulation, the follicle swells and protrudes against the capsule of the ovary. This protrusion is called stigma. When progesterone activates proteolytic enzyme present in the cells of Intrathecia indiana, this enzyme weakens the follicular capsule and causes degeneration of stigma. After about 30 minutes, the fluid begins to ooze from the follicle to the stigma. It decreases the size of follicle, causing rupture of stigma. Now the ovum is released in the follicle along with the fluid and plenty of small granulosa cells in the abdominal cavity. Neutrophils. Neutrophils, which are also known as polymer, have fine or small granules in the cytoplasm. Neutrophils play an important role in the defense mechanism of the body. Along with monocytes, the neutrophils provide the first line of defense against invading microorganisms. The neutrophils are free cells in the body and wander freely in the tissue, and practically no part of the body is spared from the leukocytosis. When neutrophils are released, a large number at the site of infection from the blood. At the same time, the new neutrophils are produced from the progenitor cells. All the neutrophils move to the diapedesis toward the site of infection due to chemotoxin. Pro and labor nephrons. Hemophilia. Hemophilia is a group of sex-linked inherited disorder characterized by prolonged clotting time. However, the bleeding time is normal. Usually it affects males, with female being a carrier. Hemophilia occurs due to lack of formation of prothrombin activator. That is why the coagulation time is prolonged. Formation of prothrombin activator is affected due to deficiency of factor 8, 9, and 10 or 11. Depending upon the deficiency of the factor involved, hemophilia is classified into three types: hemophilia A or classic hemophilia due to deficiency of factor 8. 85% of the people with hemophilia are affected by hemophilia A. Hemophilia B or Christmas disease due to deficiency of factor 9. 15% of the people with hemophilia are affected with hemophilia B. Hemophilia C or factor 11 deficiency. Due to the deficiency of factor 11, it is a very rare bleeding disorder. Effective therapy for the classical hemophilia involves replacement of the missing clotting factor. Thank you.